total amount of spending affects the rate of inflation. Too much, and inflation can rise as the economy overheats. Too little, and inflation can fall as the economy contracts. A recession. So the government has given the Bank of England the job of maintaining inflation at a steady rate of 2%. 2% is the target, but inflation will fluctuate due to unexpected events and influences. To stop prices rising too fast, the bank reduces the amount of spending in the economy by adjusting the cost of money. It does this by setting the interest rate on its dealings with financial institutions. This in turn affects the rate on savings, mortgages, overdrafts, and other loans. All of this influences how much is spent and saved, and in turn, inflation. If the bank expects inflation to be above the target, it raises interest rates. People have to pay more for the money they have borrowed and have less to spend. Some people might decide to save more. The growth in demand will gradually fall, reducing the upward pressure on prices. If the bank expects inflation to fall below the target, it will reduce interest rates to boost spending. People will pay less on their loans and have more to spend. Others may decide to save less. Changes in interest rates can take up to 2 years to have their full impact on inflation. So the bank has to look ahead to judge what it thinks inflation will be, rather than look at what it is now. This is not an exact science because judgments have to be made about the future, and that always involves uncertainty and unexpected events. If interest rates are very low, and the bank thinks inflation is still likely to fall below the target, it can inject extra money into the economy directly to stimulate demand. It can do this through quantitative easing. The bank creates new money electronically to buy government bonds and high-quality debt from financial institutions like pension funds. This cash injection lowers the cost of borrowing and boosts asset prices, supporting demand and getting inflation back to target. When conditions allow, the bank can sell the bonds to reduce the amount of money in the economy if inflation looks like being too high. Maintaining the value of money is the Bank of England's job. Our trust in the value of money is preserved, and the promise is kept.